Welcome to the Belmont Wetland. It starts here at State Highway 2 and it flows all the way down to the Hutt River, Te Awa Kairangi. This wetland was built as part of Te Wai Takamori or Te Awa Kairangi, a transformational project for Te Awa Kairangi Kitai Lower Hutt. It's a pilot scheme, and if it works here, it can be used at other sites on the river. So the Belmont Wetland acts in three ways. It slows the water, so it's actually flood protection. It purifies the water as a filter, and it's increasing ecological value with biodiversity. So it's flooding, clean water, and biodiversity. So the rushes and sedges are really good at helping to filter out some of the contaminants from the stormwater. And being so close to the road, that can include sort of petroleum distillates, chromium, lead, zinc, things like that. So in a storm event, the water can come in quite dirty, and that's when the wetland really comes into its own. So the first stage of that is the concrete forebays, and that's where the heavy particulates fall out and settle. So that's your gravel. And then it goes into the upper wetland here, the marshland, and that starts the filtration process from the second stage. That's where all your reeds and rushes are. And by the time it crosses the wall into the lower wetland, it's going through the final phase. And that's where you've got finer grasses like carex. And by the time it passed through there, the last filter, it reaches Te Awa Kairangi, the Hutt River, and it's much, much cleaner. Belmont School and Predator Free Parirahul Group came together and planted all the native trees in the surrounded areas over here and over here that you see. Belmont Wetland's really good for fish passage, even for tuna, the eels. The small fishes can come up here into the lower wetland network, and that's where they can really thrive and be sheltered. It's not all about fish though. There's other biodiversity, insects, invertebrates, even bird life and butterflies. The Belmont Wetland is an ecological restoration.